In this screencast, I'm going to go over an example of do loops in VBA. I've got a flowchart already made, and what we're doing is we're starting with a value for I of 1. We're going into this do loop, and then each time we're in this loop, or each time this loop progresses, we are multiplying the previous value of I by 1.1, so we're increasing it by 10%. And then we have inside of each loop, we have a conditional, is I greater than 20? If it is greater than 20, we're going to exit. So we're basically taking 1, multiply it by 10% over and over and over again until it exceeds 20. So while this is not true, we just repeat and we keep going and going. And then after, when I does exceed 20, we exit this loop and we display a message box for what I is, and then we end. So we're going to create VBA code for this, and we're also going to implement in here. We are going to count how many times this loop progresses, and actually, if we want to, in here, we would put another flowchart element, another box, where we're keeping track of the number of times we've iterated. So we're going to add in a count equals count plus 1. So every time we go past this point, we're going to increase that count by 1, and that will enable us to determine how many iterations of the loop had occurred. Just a few things here. There are three types of do loops in VBA. There's just a generic do loop. So generic do loop has this structure where we have do and then loop. You never want to set up a do loop, a general do loop, unless you have some way to exit. And I forgot to put it here, but you need some sort of condition that can be true. If condition, then we exit do. We exit when something is true. The other way that we can do this is a loop until. So we're going to do something until a condition is satisfied. So either way, we're exiting when something is true. And we're going to implement these now in VBA. So now I'm over in Excel. I do Alt F11 to bring up the editor. I'm going to insert a new module, and we are going to call this sub looper. First thing we need to do is dim our variables. Going back to our flowchart, we see that the variables that we need to dim are going to be I and count. So that's it, I and count. I is going to be a double because it can take on any real value, and count is going to be an integer. That's only 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, because that's the number of times that the loop has proceeded. The next step, we need to declare that I is going to be equal to 1, and then we enter this do loop. And inside the do loop, we say the beginning, I is equal to 1.1 times the previous I. And then we're going to have an if-then. This is a one-way if-then. We exit the loop. And if we don't exit the loop, then we just increment the count by 1. So I put in I equals 1. I like to set up my do loop with some space in there so I know that I end my do with a loop. I is going to be 1.1 times the old I. And now we have an if in there. So this if now is corresponding to this diamond. So if I is greater than 20, then we exit do. This is known as a one-way one-liner. You don't need an end if. And then the next, if we don't exit the loop, then we increment count by 1. So count equals count plus 1. And that should be it for our loop. So we loop back after we're through and after we exit the do, then we need to display a message box. And I've just said message box after space and count and space iterations. I has a value of space and quotations and I. So this is just going to say, for example, after 20 iterations, I has a value of whatever. I think we're all ready to go. I'm going to press F8 now to step through this. We can look down here in the locals window. I is equal to 1. And now we're going to do. So now I is equal to 1.1. If I greater than 20, then we exit do. So at this point, it's not greater than 20. Count starts out at 0, but then when I proceed through that, we increment count by 1, and we keep going. And what's happening, if you look down here, is that I is increasing by 10% each time, and we keep going and going and going. And after a bunch of iterations, exponential growth, so we're at 19.19. I go back up here. Now we've incremented that to less than 20 to over than 20. So now this should be true. We exit the do, and we have a message box. After 31 iterations, I has a value of 21.11377, and so on. Let me just show you one more thing. I'm going to put a format number here. We're going to format I to two places after the decimal. So I'm going to run this now, and you see that 21.11 is now, is rounded now to two decimal places. So that's how we can use a do loop. We can also, I'm going to remove this. I'm going to show you how we can do this with a loop until. So loop until I greater than 20. Same thing, run this, and it does the exact same thing. After 32 iterations, I has a value of 21.1. So now I want to just very quickly show you, let's say instead of having false on the left here, as we did before, and true on the right, we switch it. So now we have true in the inside. So now we have I less than or equal to 20. If that's true, then we stay in the loop. So this looks a little bit different. It is called a do while. So do while means you're in the loop when something is true. So let's implement this in our code. Instead of loop until, so I'm going to put it up here, do while I less than or equal to 20. And we're doing the same thing. So when I run through this using F8, I is less than 20. I is increasing as it did before. We keep going and going and going. In all these cases, we're in the loop when something is true. So right now, I is 15.8, which is less than 20, so that's a true statement. And I keep going, and now this is not true, because now I is 21.1, so we exit the loop, and we have a message box. So these are all equivalent ways of doing things. We have the do, the general do loop, we have the do and loop until, and then we have the do while. You get the same thing. The only difference is, are you in the loop when something is true or when something is false?